Alibaba led losses in Hong Kong after its shares plunged more than 10% on Friday. That's as the Chinese e-commerce giant announced it had scrapped plans to spin off its $11 billion cloud computing unit, citing uncertainties over US export controls on chips related to artificial intelligence. The drop, potentially its biggest one-day fall in more than a year, wiped about $20 billion off its market value. The Chinese tech giant first revealed plans to split into six units in March, spurring hopes for a wave of listings that would increase shareholder value and boost growth. It also follows the company's disappointing third quarter earnings announced on Thursday. Alibaba's US listed securities closed down 9% following the news. For more on this now, let's bring in Neil Wilson. He's Chief Market Analyst at Finalto. Thanks for being with us this morning, Neil. Now, a lot going on at Alibaba at the moment. Cancelled plans for separate listings, lackluster earnings, and the sale of founder Jack Ma's shares. Are investors losing appetite for the company?
Well, I think, market conditions have changed a fair bit. Things have changed a fair bit since the restructuring was announced. You got a big uplift from that announcement of the restructuring earlier this year. Shareholders were quite keen on the idea that they'd be able to unlock more value from all the various parts of the company. But we've seen, Chinese shares come off quite a bit this year. We've seen that sort of euphoria from the reopening from COVID not really persist, and growth has been a bit lackluster in China. And then you've got this key problem with the US export controls on these key chips. So it's forcing a lot of these Chinese tech companies to use quite outdated chips, some from 2017 that have been discontinued.
Interesting.
And that right. gives them a bit of a, they're on the back foot in terms of their cloud division.
Right. Now, on that note, Presidents Biden and Xi agreed to resume high-level talks. Can we expect to see trade agreements between the world's two largest economies to end this chip war?
I think that's probably pushing it. I think we have seen some warmer words, if you like. But I think these are some key sort of strategic decisions, and it's a key strategic advantage that the White House has identified. And I don't think that the US is likely to give up that sort of control just yet. I mean, what in government might be, we don't know. But I don't see much from the US side in terms of giving up that control of the chips. It's a key thing now, strategically, geopolitically, going forward, is this AI battle. And I think the US has realized it's got a really big advantage there, and it can outpace China quite rapidly now.
Right. Neil Wilson, thank you for your insights. Now to other top stories from around the world. Egypt has completed its largest asset sale this year, offloading 30% of the country's biggest tobacco company for $625 million. The United Arab Emirates-based Global Investment Holding bought some 699 million shares at 79 cents apiece. The fundraising is hoped to bring in more dollar reserves, with the country facing its worst foreign currency crunch in years. Oil prices have fallen around 5% to their lowest in 4 months, amid signs of increased supply and fears of worsening global demand. Analysts say uncertainty over higher US interest rates and weak economic prints from Japan, China, and the Eurozone are all contributing factors. Investors have now turned their focus to an OPEC meeting next week for 2024 forecasts. And shares in Burberry fell 10% after the company announced it was unlikely to meet its annual revenue growth forecast. The British luxury fashion house also reported a sharp drop in comparable store sales growth, down from 18% in the previous quarter to 1%. The slowdown in luxury spending is being attributed to rising inflation and economic uncertainty.